does the door look like?
The red door.
Nice. What type of handle?
A brass handle.
Excellent. The door is going to come, is going to open. Does it open in or out?
Out.
Very nice. Someone who knows Kristian very well is going to come out and assist you. Who comes out?
An angel.
Beautiful. And any description of the angel that you may be able to give?
I can't see a face. I see like an outline of light, almost like translucent light, and wings, but not fully formed, just like half-formed wings. But what I mean by that is it's the shape of wings, but you don't see like feathers, only part feathers.
An outline, a silhouette.
Yeah.
Excellent. And I want you to introduce yourself, please. Mm-hmm. And what's the response?
It's Michael.
Oh, very good. Can Michael hear me speaking?
Yes.
Very good. Is it, Michael, do you prefer that we stay here at the door, or do we move somewhere else?
Follow him.
Very good. Do you mind? Athena?
No.
Very good. Then follow, please. How are you moving?
Floating. Yeah, I'm getting different images.
Well, you could describe anything that flashes or anything that you see as you're traveling.
I just got an image of a clear field and a bright sunny day. And we moved through that. And I keep seeing like rings of Saturn.
Let's get to where he's taking you in the count of 5, 4, 3, halfway there, 2, and 1. Where are you now?
I see rings of Saturn or of some kind of planet. Iones?
Iones, very nice. And where is this Iones?
Seventh dimension.
Seventh, beautiful.
I see spaceships parked all around.
I have to make an emergency to the little boy's room. Can you let him show you around and keep talking, please?
Yeah.
Sorry, what is this place? Is it a dock?
No, it's... It just looks like... kind of a... The ground is gray. But the rings that I see in front of me are very vibrant. And the spaceships are gray and... almost like eight sides, hexagonal or hexy shaped or something like that.
Understood. And Michael, is this where Kristian is from?
Yes.
Did he come from this place before he decided to incarnate on the earth?
Yes.
Does Athena have an expression of herself in this place as well?
Yeah.
Just for the sake of it, could you spell the name of this place again?
Ionyos.
So this is a seventh dimensional expression.
Yeah.
What else would he like to show you? As a matter of fact, the spaceships, what are they used for?
What are they used for?
Yes.
Transportation. Exploration.
And can these particular ships move through the dimensions?
Yes.
Are any of these ships located in Ottawa, Canada, where Kristian and Athena live?
No.
Very good. So they never visit their third dimensional expressions?
No.
Very good. And Michael, what else could you tell us? Something of significance about this place, please.
It's where they're going to come back to.
After the shift?
No. Another time. Another place. After they evolve, I keep seeing the number 5. Maybe it's 5 evolutions more.
Is it after they ascend the 5D at the 5th dimension?
Yeah.
Paris. But soon, after maybe a great event, they will awaken to their true reality of being in the fifth dimension. And then after that, they'll be able to return to this place.
Yeah.
Very good. Is there anything else that you'd like to express to us about this place, or is there somewhere else you'd like to take us?
There's nothing else in this place.
Very good. Well, we're following you, then. Where else would you like her to follow you? Are you moving to somewhere else?
Yeah.
Oh, very good. Very appreciative. While you're traveling, can you ask them, what was the name of the race on Saturn, those seventh dimensional beings, for reference?
I'm waiting for it. Not coming.
That's okay. I'd like you to look at yourself. What form are you in?
Half alien, half human. In my face.
And what about your hands?
They're very short, my fingers. But they're not shaped like human fingers. They're kind of pointy and greeny gray.
As you're traveling, I want you to just look to the side and you'll see a full reflection of you.
I have two legs. I'm medium size. I have human hair. Long brown hair. And human eyes. But my skin is kind of rubbery looking. And a bit shiny.
Very nice. This is an expression of Athena. Is this the same form that Kristian had as well?
Yes.
And you're going to get to where you're going in a count of 3, 2, and 1. Where are you now?
On a bunch of standing on clouds. Looking into the earth.
Michael, what are you showing her?
Again, it's an image of Kristian sticking his hands out beside Michael and vibrating his hands and vibrations being, they're showering vibrations onto the earth. The whole earth.
Is there, excuse me, is there an expression of Kristian and Archangel Michael
it's continuous, and both Michael and Kristian are in angel form.
Beautiful. And this, I say, unconditional love, for lack of a better word, this high vibration, is it helping with the consciousness shift on the planet?
Yes.
What else can you elaborate about this expression of Kristian? And why is it just Kristian and Michael alone?
Because Kristian is almost like, is a template of Michael in that he's like an apprentice. He has the same kind of energy. It's like a healing energy. And when they shake, or when they shower the earth with high vibration, I'm just following the vibration down into the earth to see what the impact is. So it hits someone's vibration level, their aura, if I can call it that, the light around them, and it expands their aura. Their aura grows, and I see colors changing. And then now, as I follow it, I see an expansion and a contagion of the aura, so that it flows from person to person to person to person.
So there's a ripple effect.
Yeah.
From everyone.
Every single person. And when I see someone who has low vibration, they're not excluded. Everyone's a part of it.
In real time, did you find my aspect?
Yes.
Place it around my throat?
Yes.
You see the change in my aura?
I saw black, and it's shifting colors. It's going through the rainbow of colors.
Beautiful.
Around your throat.
Was there something attached there? Or just?
Just a black, like smoke fog. Right into the middle of your throat.
And Michael, can you tell me what that was or what that is? Or is that an anomaly that I created myself?
Bad energy.
That I've created myself?
Yeah, negative energy.
That's interesting. I wonder how I did that.
What's come forward is I'm being told impure thoughts. I don't know what that means, but just not 100% positive, pure intention somewhere.
Oh, very good. Are they able to remove it?
gone.
Thank you. What else is there significant about?
With the earth or with you?
No, just with the earth.
That's it. That's all I'm seeing. Was the aura and the color shift.
It was very important for Kristian to understand that. Seeing him and Michael over the planet. At one point, the energy that they're constantly sending, will the planet then shift into a higher vibration? Or, you know, recognize that it's in the fifth dimension. What's the outcome of this procedure?
It will shift. But there's lots of work to be done. Because lots need to increase their vibration.
And is there another place that you'd like to take us to as well, for Kristian's sake?
No, just on the clouds.
Oh, very good. Well, we have a list of questions that Kristian was really interested in. And as anyone who's listening may tell, that Athena, because her heart is so open, she's decided to do a session for her husband. He really had a desire to know, or he wanted you to elaborate when he was sleepwalking, headed toward the jungle. And he said before, he already knows, but he felt that Athena would be able to get more than that. What was he going to be shown in that jungle?
Vibration. Physical vibration.
So in a sense, he would have been able to see the auras of the life in the jungle?
And not just of animals, but of plants, of earth, of what one would think to be non-living things that in fact have an aura and a vibration.
And he was being shown at a very young age. What was the purpose of that?
To show the interconnectedness between all things.
And because the guard stopped him, was he given another opportunity to make that trip?
No.
Had a desire too. Why just that one time?
There were other times, but he couldn't receive the invitation. He wasn't able to see or accept.
Even at such a young age?
No, other times when he was older, but as a child, he was given the invitation because of his ability to experience wonder and not be afraid and newness.
He'd like to know, may he experience this experience again.
It's only him who is stopping himself. Yes, he can experience it. He has to state his desire and intention, believe it, and then he will see.
Excellent.
And if he doesn't see, it's because he's blocking it.
He himself is blocking it.
Yes.
Maybe he should try and go in eyes wide open this time.
Yeah.
What is Christian's special gift that he brought to the planet Earth?
Healing.
Has it all already activated, or is it yet to be activated?
It's in process, but not not physical healing, as in I'm gonna fix your broken leg. More like energy healing.
Expanding consciousness.
Yeah.
Light information.
Yes.
Beautiful. And how?
I see, I'm being shown that he's a master, or will be a master, of this gift, or of this communication, or I don't know what it is, but he'll become a master.
And this is what he'll be doing while he's still physically manifest on the planet as Kristian, and then after the shift?
Yes, and then when he shifts, he'll be doing it too. It will continue. But it'll grow. His powers and abilities will grow as he grows, so they'll grow, and he and his powers will grow in parallel, in concert.
In a session before this, Athena said the shift would take place in 2020 or 2021. Is that still accurate?
Yes.
Very good. What are Christian's dreams about? They're more and more vivid and very suggestive, and he's wondering, are they attempts at contact? Or is he just awakening? Or is he receiving downloads?
It's all those things, yes. But he's only getting, if I can call it, introductory pieces from all of these, because he's not fully awakened, so he's only getting that from which he is able to receive.
Where he's resonating.
Yes.
What do you suggest he do to help with his vibrational resonance? To increase it?
He can't control it, in that he can't force it to happen.
Understood.
So he continues to be open, and the biggest thing is to believe it will happen and set the intentions and practice it. Feel the auras, see the auras, and then allow them to reveal themselves.
Excellent. His chakras as well.
They're opening. Yeah.
Do you suggest it?
I suggest that as one piece of different aspects that will help him.
Excellent. And may you elaborate on any other aspects?
Continue to seek out those things that are true, that are authentic, and that reveal themselves as truth.
Very good. Now, what is he going to do with the downloads after having received them?
They're going to go through his body, and I have an image of a puzzle, piece by piece, they'll come into form, and over time, the bigger picture, the bigger puzzle, will be completed.
Excellent. As it's completed, he'll know what to do.
Yes.
Beautiful. Now you showed us the one race of ETs. Kristian had a desire to know what other races of ETs are he interacting with.
I got the word Shishani.
I think Bashar spoke about the Shishani. Aren't they the ones that are going to be the first to land on the earth?
I don't know.
Did you ask Michael?
Yes.
What does he say?
Yes, they are.
Wow, very good. And what is his connection to the Shishani? Expression of himself?
Yes, I'm getting that he was there as well. I see him there.
Beautiful. What's his position there? How did he get chosen, or how did he decide to choose to be ground crew, to take a human body?
I don't understand the question.
Okay. I'd like to ask Michael, say Michael, oh, I'm asking Michael directly, how did Kristian, as a Shishani, decide to take a physical body as Kristian? Why?
Because it was a mission. Like a special mission. I see images of tears and negativity and greed. And I see him wiping tears. And fixing things.
Kristian, as a multidimensional personality, one aspect, he's an apprentice for you, Lord Michael. And then he's a Shishani. And then the aspect of him on the seventh dimension in Saturn. Is there an aspect where all these lives, of course, are simultaneously, correct?
Yeah.
species?
Yes.
What was the name of the race on the Saturn?
Was it Iones?
Oh, that's what, that was the name of them? Okay. I thought that was just the name of the place, Iones. Very good. For some reason, this was very important to Kristian. Because he believed, that he had a connection with the Pleiades as well. Or Pleiadian. Would that be accurate?
Yes.
No, these are directly his questions. And with that particular group, what's his mission or purpose for taking a physical body?
It's all of the same mission. Fixing, changing, adjusting the earth.
This soul group, is Athena connected to the soul group as well?
Yes.
Any of these particular ET races as well?
Not all.
He had a desire to know. Was he on any councils? Are you on? Is he a member of any councils?
The Palladian Council.
And his position on that particular council?
An advisor.
Is it safe to say that what he's doing on the planet Earth, he's done it elsewhere in the cosmos?
In terms of
raising the vibration.
Yes.
And Athena as well.
Yes.
He had a desire to know how many times has he taken on a physical form on the earth as a human.
25 times.
Probably split in half male and female?
Yes.
Had he been other animals as well, or?
Yes. Plants as well.
Oh, very good. He wanted to know.
Sorry, I just got an image of a spider. He was a spider at one time.
Beautiful. Any aquatic animals?
A dolphin.
And when he was a dolphin, that's an advanced race on the planet Earth, is it not?
They're intelligent.
Okay. Is he part of a particular oversoul?
Yes.
Could you elaborate? Excuse me once again, I don't know what's going on here. soul?
What is the question?
He wanted to know, did his oversoul have a name or a designation?
I guess
when he thinks of himself being a template for Archangel Michael, would that be his oversoul?
Yes.
You were going to say something, and I interrupted. What were you going to say in your own words?
Just that his oversoul is complex.
Is what?
His oversoul is complex. Has lots of layers to it. If I can say that, I'm seeing like helial layers. Can you?
That makes it very, not that it's better than anything else, but sort of special.
Well, can you have over souls of oversouls? Because that's what I'm seeing, oversouls of oversouls.
All the way back to source?
Yes.
Would he be considered a hand of God?
I wouldn't say hand of God.
Okay.
I wouldn't articulate it like that, but
I want you to ask Michael. So you don't have some things.
He's saying a reflection of God?
Yes. But we all are that. We all are.
An image of God, that's what I'm being told.
Very good. So basically, the reason why he incarnated on the earth, because this is one of his questions, was to be on this mission to help. How significant is the transition that's taking place on the planet Earth, and what will it do once the shift has happened? What will happen to the entire universe?
I'm seeing like an image of an escalator where you keep going up floors. So it will be like going to the next rung or floor of consciousness.
And will it start on the earth, like the first domino?
Yes, and so in between each rung or each full escalator are like 5 levels. So you're not just going up one rung. Essentially, you're going up 5, if you're following.
Beautiful. Those who aren't prepared to go, or who have decided not to?
I see them falling, just free falling.
And those are the ones that aren't prepared. And what about the ones who have just chosen not to? Because they're not finished.
They'll just stay on Earth.
And before, when you gave us a how it would look, you said it's almost like a new Earth. It'll be in the same space, but just in different dimensions, where one won't be able to to perceive the other.
Yeah, I'm getting a screen, like a screenshot of Earth, but far more beautiful, more vibrant, positive images of people being free to choose their heart's desire.
Beautiful. Do you see Kristian, Athena, Hank, and Eddie on the snow earth?
Yes, and their children.
Beautiful. It's pretty bold from our perspective to say 2020 or 2021. How is it so easy to just, is that where so many things have happened to where that's not the timeline and nothing can change it or switch it?
Yeah, it's like a whoosh, a rapid opening that pressure's been building and building, and it's like a ship vessel that will burst. It can't withstand any more pressure, and so it's like a rapid kind of, it will happen in that sense, but not physically. Metaphorically, it will have to burst, but physically, it will happen gradually. In a way in which people will not feel the pressure, but they will be able to ascend in a safe, comfortable, natural way.
And we're still thinking about 2020, 2021.
2021.
Beautiful. So as far as, you know, what's important now to us, the type of jobs and all of those things, how significant will any of that struggle be for the survival mode that we're in after the shift?
Insignificant. You'll be able to, well, essentially there is no work, but if you want to explore what it is to be a healer, you can just do that. You can do whatever you want.
This timeline that we're speaking of, and so it's already in the process right now.
Yes.
And within the next 3 years, this year 17, next year 18, 19, 20, this is that gradual speeding.
There's a building of pressure.
Call it the compression breakthrough. That's what I've heard it called, from Cobra. Are you familiar with the entity Cobra here on the planet Earth? Michael?
Yes.
Would he be a legitimate source of valuable information?
Yes.
Beautiful. He wanted to know which planet he incarnated on the most. And I just like getting his answers. So that's very interesting. Let's just say his physicality. And in this universe as opposed to another dimension.
I'm getting images of the Earth.
Oh, very good.
Starseed Brothers?
From Pliny, Shishani, from which?
Shishani?
Can you get an image of what the Shishani look like, please?
Yes.
Thank you.
It's almost like a white gray, but not like a gray-gray, but a very light white, smooth-skinned, long, round head, big eyes, tall, human-like fingers, but the same kind of consistent coloring and texture to the skin. No hair.
Amazing. When will the Shishani? It'll have to be when they'll land after the shift. They'll land after the shift, then, correct? Or will they land before?
After.
Okay. Is it asking too much to know when?
2025.
Beautiful. And when we're given dates like this, are these just probabilities or propensities, or this is the timeline that's set before us?
Everything is in a state of change and flux, and so these are very good guidelines, but the world is, the universe, the everything is changing, and so we don't tie ourselves to an exact date, but we know that it's a good approximation.
Lives. Is there anything in any of his past lives? And we call past lives because we understand everything is happening simultaneously in the forever moment of now. But what are there other aspects of him affecting this aspect of him as Kristian? Yeah, that's the way to put it. Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay, very good.
I'm getting an image of him as being angry. And I'm waiting to understand what that is. Of him being locked up. There was a time he was locked up. Like in prison, in a jail for a crime he didn't commit. And he became very angry.
Bitter.
Very distrustful. Disillusioned.
Was this another expression of him on the earth?
Yes. He felt powerless.
That's understood. And how was that affecting him in this life here?
When he gets too quickly, he gets angry and feels powerless and feels like he can't control, and so he goes back to that place of anger and disillusionment and distrust.
Okay.
and becomes angry and not bitter, but hard. Hard. Unwavering, unforgiving.
Now that he can see that that was from another expression of himself and not this particular expression of himself, can he let it go?
Yes. What he's being given right now is the key to open up that gel cell and walk free.
Are all of our physical incarnations coming up for release now in this shift?
Yes. Yes.
Which is why things from other expressions, even though it's from another expression, it seems so real and tangible.
Yeah.
But it's good. It's good to know. So now you can make some different choices.
And that you're not held prisoner any longer.
Beautiful. He was wondering, why did he and Athena choose to come together on this planet?
They have complementary vibrations. It's like yin and yang.
Beautiful.
Parts of them are opposite, but they're, but like the force of magnets, they're pulled together.
How many physical incarnations have they taken together?
Lots.
On this earth and on other planets as well?
Yes.
Would you consider them soulmates?
Yes.
Beautiful. How often or in terms of percentages, do soulmates find each other?
20%.
Do most write it into their contract or their mission? For lack of a better word.
The intention is there, but it doesn't always see itself through.
Understood. Is there anything else that you could elaborate, Michael, on Kristian and Athena's relationship? Something they hadn't thought about that would make them smile?
No.
Has Athena ever been the husband and Kristian the wife?
Yes.
That's pretty significant there, I would say. What? Maybe? Yeah. Just from our perspective. Okay.
Yeah.
What is Christian's passion? His question. What is his passion?
To model to others. To figure out those things that are difficult to discern.
Considering only in 4 more years, with this major shift taking place, was wondering about the type of job that he has. Should he just keep it and ride it through?
Yes.
And also, the area of the world that he lives in. Should he just stay put and ride it through?
Yes, with both. Part of what's going to help for his evolution is to remain where he is and learn how to fulfill his mission within those constraints. If you can call it constraints.
Okay. Excellent. He had a desire for you to show Athena one of his past lives, maybe even a life that they lived together, and he desired for her to experience it. Could you just take us through a brief experience in another expression of Athena and Kristian? Something joyful.
It's a group of First Nations, like a communal group in the early days when Indigenous people, they flourished. Yes.
Like I said, every time that we do these sessions, the story is always so perfect. My last question, of course, you know, won't be my last, but Athena, working with Indigenous tribes, is there something that she could be, or that you would suggest with her working with the Indigenous tribes?
Yes, to listen to her heart and follow her passion. So when she hears Indigenous drumming, it speaks to her and overwhelms her heart. So listen to that and allow yourself to be overwhelmed.
Allow ourselves to feel it, just to feel it.
And to know, to recognize that that's where your passion lies. To connect with your roots, your ancestry.
So it's a good idea then.
Yes. It's where authenticity lives. And high vibration lives.
One of the questions I thought we were finished, which is really interesting, the purpose for showing all of the lives that he's been able to see in this session, that she's been able to see in this session for him. What is the purpose for showing him so much, such amazing detail? says a lot of this for him is totally new. But he seems to be on a fast forward track through to truth and expansion.
The purpose is to show him many sides, many facets of what he was, what he is, what he can be.
Beautiful. Right now he's with the children, but can you scan his body and scan Athena's body as well? And even scan Hank's body, if you will, with your unconditional light from head to toe. How is Athena's healing coming up, taking place, coming about? Almost complete?
Wonderful progress.
Beautiful. And what about Kristian? Is there anything he needs to focus on, lifestyle changes or anything to that effect?
No, just focus on the path that you've identified. He knows.
Excellent. Thank you very much for that. Now I stopped recording and I'm going to start recording again. Athena, do you mind asking a question for myself?
Okay.
Could you have them scan my body from head to toe and tell me anything that I need to be focused on for improvement?
Forgiveness.